administration is not only against broad economic sanctions and against apartheid, we are for a new South Africa, a new nation where all that has been built up over generations is not destroyed, a new society where participation in the social, cultural, and political life is open to all peoples, a new South Africa that comes home to the family of free nations where she belongs. To achieve that, we need not a Western withdrawal, but deeper involvement by the Western business community as agents of change and progress and growth. The international business community needs not only to be supported in South Africa, but energized. We'll be at work on that task. If we wish to foster the process of transformation, one of the best vehicles for change is through the involvement of black South Africans in business, job-related activities, and labor unions. But the vision of a better life cannot be realized so long as apartheid endures and instability reigns in South Africa. If the peoples of Southern Africa are to prosper, leaders and peoples of the region of all races will have to elevate their common interests above their ethnic divisions. We and our allies cannot dictate to the government of a sovereign nation, nor should we try. But we can offer to help find a solution that is fair to all the people of South Africa. We can volunteer to stand by and help bring about dialogue between leaders of the various factions and groups that make up the population of South Africa. We can counsel and advise and make it plain to all that we are there as friends of all the people of South Africa. In that tormented land, the window remains open for peaceful change. For how long, we know not. But we in the West, privileged and prosperous and free, must not be the ones to slam it shut. Now is a time for healing. The people of South Africa, of all races, deserve a chance to build a better future.